Good morning, good afternoon, good night. Wherever you're watching this from, welcome to Assem Live. This is Assem Sports. Chilly, cold, windy Tuesday. Coming off an action-packed weekend of football and soccer. The game is always in motion and locomotion. It's now the turn of the Euro qualifiers, where the usual suspects are always the ones who qualify. England, France, Germany, Spain. Thank you for tuning into Assem Sports. We're going to get down to the rundown of the games that went on in the Euro qualifiers, and the teams who've made it through. More games are going on today, but it's just a formality, and I can't wait for all this Euros and international break to be over so the Premier League, the upper echelon, returns this weekend. But the games that went on yesterday had England playing against North Macedonia, and the shouting and the fans screaming for Gareth Southgate to be fired again, because England played 1-1 with San Marino at home. Away from home. Sometimes some of the English fans, what they complain about is not justified. Your team has already qualified. So I didn't really understand why they were angry. Of course, North Macedonia, remember, was the team that stopped Italy from qualifying to the last Euros. So even though they're a small nation, they do play some good football. They gave England a tough time. 1-1 was the final score. Czech Republic beat Moldova 3-0. Albania beat Faroe Islands. Ukraine against Italy was a game that had a controversial call at the end. The Ukrainians were screaming for a penalty after Mykhailo Mudryk was brought down in the penalty box, but the referee said no. 0-0 was the final score, and that score gives Italy a return to the Euros after 2 years of being in obscurity. A draw is all they needed, and a draw is what they got. So England has qualified France, Germany, Spain, Portugal, Italy, Belgium, Netherlands, Croatia, Denmark, Slovenia. It's the usual suspects. So, I mean, I just think that they could find a different way to make the qualification based upon your yearly ranking, and allow these other teams to get more playing time and the cream rises to the top to play the big boys. Instead of the amount of players that have been injured during this Euro qualifier series and how it's going to affect the clubs they play with. It's a big conversation that is not being stated enough. And the amount of tournaments, the amount of games these professionals are being forced to play. It never used to be like that. I know the higher the money, the higher the stakes, and the higher the games, but for how long can these people play these games? Until we see, players collapsing on the field? Penny, for your thoughts, thank you for tuning into Assem Sports. Greece is playing France today. The last batch of games in the Euros is going down today, where Greece is playing France. Andorra is playing Israel. France, mind you, beat Gibraltar 14-0. Belgium beat Azerbaijan, I think 5-0. Romelu Lukaku got 4 goals. So these games are usually, sometimes it looks like a training session for some of these teams against these lower seeded teams. And I feel it would be better if the lower seeded teams gather together and play among themselves, and the best amongst them gets an automatic qualification to play with the big boys. Penny, for your thoughts. Gibraltar, after being walloped 14-0, let's see how much Netherlands are going to score them. Romania playing Switzerland, Kosovo, Belarus, Croatia is playing Armenia, Wales is playing Turkey. Thank you for watching Assem Sports. The Premier League returns this weekend with a mouth-watering game, blockbuster game, Manchester City against Liverpool. The whispers in the air. Okay, the people are talking in relation to the timing of the game. Should the Premier League save the big games for later in the day than playing it early in the morning when it comes to the British time? Who decides what time these games are played, and what are the factors that go into the decision making for picking which games are played when? Because, I mean, For someone like me, I don't understand. From the perspective of a Liverpool or a Man City, who have players who travel on an international level, you should give them a little bit of breathing space so they can play their game later in the day. It's just common sense. But I guess today, in today's world, common sense doesn't apply. It is all about the dollar. It's all about the cities. It's all about the cents. It's all about, so yes, I think Jurgen Klopp has said that before. He's still humping on it. Pep Guardiola has also made certain pronouncements to allude to the fact that the games are too much. And after they play all these tournaments and they come back to their clubs, the big clubs with more international players should be given breathing space. And the other clubs who don't have a lot of international players, the games should be structured and the fixtures should be scheduled around that. Let me know what you think about it. Thank you for tuning in to Asem Sports. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0, new ASEA music collection, available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. This has been Asem Sports. More music on the way, but the channel coming soon. ASEA, over that tip.